I just take copper. The copper sheet that's left over. I can even use wire from like my Romex from the house if you have a little bit of that left over. You know what I do is I put the silver on the bottom because the silver is going to melt before the copper. So I want the bulk of the flame to be on the copper. We may have to fire up the big torch, but I think I'll try it with a small torch first. Same rules apply. You guys all see? I don't flux it. The copper really does not like to melt.
Don't flux it because there's flux in the crucible or because
I want it to be as dirty as I can get it. There we go. Normally you want a flame that just covers it. And I would easily use the oxyacetylene right now, but I want people to be able to see. And it's really hard to see through those dark glasses, so. And the key to this is to get this metal thoroughly mixed. Now at home, I have a giant welding style torch that I do this with. Give me a solder pen. Thanks, sir. Just get everything together. Oh yeah, looking good. This alloy will always be Shibuichi, but it might not texture. Sometimes, for some reason, I can't even tell you why, it won't texture. See those crusty bits? Mm-hmm. That's the copper. Copper's very stubborn. I'm gonna get this a little hot too. Copper's very stubborn. So when you start doing the Aunt Jemima, right, what you're looking for is like angles of copper sheet that haven't melted poking out. You don't want to see that. See that? You see that sheet in there? See that kind of like, see that? So that's still sheet. Isn't that gorgeous? Looking for all of that bad stuff. I want a nice homogeneous mix. See that? Looking great. Loving it. Love in it. Take a break from it for a minute. Whoa, isn't that beautiful? Make sure that there's none of that crap in there. Now, I can tell if it's a good ingot, good meaning that's going to do what I want it to do. By the way it looks, what I'm looking for is it cools off against this like charcoal, like a chocolate or eggplant kind of brown. And as it cools, fissures develop in the surface and cracks. Not deep ones, but just cracks in the oxide. You have to see kind of the salmon color. And then I'm like a coppery salmon color. Then I kind of know it's worked. It's starting to happen.